Okay, welcome back. I went ahead and I did rows 4 and 5 so that we would be on the same place here for row 22. Of course, you've gone and you've redone your 4 rows 3 times, and then you do rows 4 and 5 again, and then it brings you to row 22, which is where I am right now. Oof. Oh, sorry about that noise. So for row 22, we'll be doing a chain of 4, 1, 2, 3, and 4, and then you'll turn. Beginning of row 22, you will do 2 double crochets worked in the first chain space. 1, 2, and then you will do front post double crochet around the next stitch. So this first, let me get a little closer here. This first post, oh, where are you? Here we go. This first post here, you'll want to do a front post double crochet. Ah, there we go. There. Now, the repeat is, let me highlight it for myself here. Okay, so we do the front post double crochet and then double crochet in the next 3 stitches. So you're working in the stitches now. You'll do a double crochet in the next 3 stitches. 1, 2, and 3. And then again, this is the double crochet that you just did and above this double crochet. So in the next post, you'll be doing another front post double crochet. And then they want you to do a V stitch in the next, they want you to skip a stitch. So we're going to be skipping this next stitch. And then in the next, we'll be working a V stitch. And V stitches consist of 1 double crochet, chain 1, then another double crochet, all worked in that same stitch. Then again, skip another stitch, and then you'll be repeating. So the repeat is again, since I want you to skip a stitch, you'll be skipping this one. So the repeat will start here. You'll start with a front post double crochet, then 1 double crochet in the next 3 stitches. So 1, 2, and 3. And then in the next post, you'll work a front post. So basically it's going to be front post, 3 double crochets, front post. That's one section of it. And then you'll skip a stitch. Then in the next, you'll work a V stitch, which is double crochet, chain 1, double crochet. And then you'll skip a stitch. So basically the next section is skip a stitch, V stitch, skip a stitch. And then you'll repeat this again. Front post, 3 double crochets, front post. So we did our V stitch and skip a stitch, and then we'll begin our next, which is front post. Then your 3 double crochets, your 1 double crochet worked in the next 3 stitches. So we got our 3 double crochets and then front post. So you're basically having 2 front posts on either side of your 3 double crochets. And then your V section that you'll do next is skip a stitch, then a V stitch, and then skip a stitch. And that's your next section. Skip a stitch, V stitch, skip a stitch. Then you'll begin your next section of front post double crochet, then your 3 double crochets, 1, 2, and 3, and then finish off that little section by doing a front post double crochet. So again, front post double crochet, 1, 2, 3 double crochets, and then front post. And then again, you'll do your skip a stitch, V stitch, skip a stitch, and then start again on your front post. You'll do this all the way on this side row until you make it to the very corner here. And they say you do it until you have at least 3 stitches. She says Lion Brand says 3 stitches from the corner. I'm hoping I will, but I'm doing it this row a lot earlier. So I'm not sure how many I'll have, but you should have at least 3 stitches before the end. So this would be my skip a stitch, and I would start here. So it won't be 3 stitches for me. So keep doing that, and I'll show you what to do at the end. Sorry about that construction. Okay, so you should have 3 stitches here before the end. Then they want you to do work these last 3 stitches as a front post. And then they want you to put a double crochet in the next 2 stitches. So right before the corner, you should have double crochet, front post, double crochet. And in the center, they want you to work, hold on, find where I am here. Oh, on the next 2 stitches. And then in the center, they want you to work a double crochet, chain 2, and a double crochet in the center area, double crochet, chain 2, double crochet, and then working on the next side, you'll be repeating what you did on the other side, so you'll have double crochet worked in the next 2 stitches, and then a front post double crochet. And then you'll go back to the repeat again. So they want you to skip the next stitch, and then in the next do your V stitch, which is double crochet, chain 1, double crochet, all worked in the same stitch. Then again, you will skip 1 stitch, and then you'll begin your front post double crochet, then 1 double crochet in the next 3 stitches. And then your front post double crochet worked in the next. And then again, you will skip 1 stitch, V stitch, skip 1 stitch, and then you'll start again with your front post, 3 double crochets, front post. You're back on track until you get to your, what they call your turning chain, which is this last space here. Okay, I'm getting on to the end here. I have my front post double crochet. Then I'm doing my 3 double crochets. 1, 2, and 3. Then I'm gonna finish this little section by finishing my front post double crochet. Now I'm on the end turning chain, and they want you to do 2 double crochets worked in this turning chain space. And then chain 1 and do a double crochet in the 3rd chain as usual. And that finishes row 22. Okay, for row 23, you'll be chaining 4. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Turn. And they want you to double crochet 2 in this first space. And then they want you to do a back, wait, and then double crochet in the next 2 stitches, 1 and 2, and then in this back post, I mean this post here, as you can see on this side it's front post, but working on it from this direction, they're back post. They want you to continue to line up. See how they're all lined up? So when you're on this side, you'll be doing front post. And when you're on the back side, like we are right here, you'll be doing back post to continue the post to be lined. So here, you'll be doing your back post worked on this side. Then you'll repeat will start. Double crochet 1 in the next 3 stitches, 1, 2, and 3, and then again back post in the next stitch, just like that. Back post, 3 double crochets, then back post. And then now you have your V stitch. They want you to skip a stitch, which is basically this stitch of the V stitch. They want you to work in the center of the V stitch and put another V-stitch in there, which is double crochet, chain one, double crochet. Then again, skip this next stitch, which is the V-stitch again, and basically they want you just to go on into this next section and repeat it, which will be back post, double crochet, three double crochets, back post, double crochets. So it's like the opposite of what we were doing before. Instead of doing front post and three double crochets, we'll be doing back post and then working one double crochet in the next three stitches. And then do a back post. And then work a V-stitch in the center V-stitch. V-stitches are double crochet, chain one, double crochet. And then again, find your next back post here and do a back post. I'm going to be repeating this row until you get to, it says until you get to three stitches before the point. I don't know, because my piece is smaller, I don't know how many stitches I'll have, but you should have three stitches before the point and then stop, and I'll show you what you need to do. To the last three stitches before my center chain two space, and they want me to double crochet in the next three stitches. So one, two, and three. Then in the big space, they want you to do two double crochets, worked in this big space on the end, chain one, then another double crochet worked in this middle space, then chain two, and then another double crochet worked in the center space, then chain one, and then work two more double crochets in this center space. So now you've got this big thing on the end. Hope I was in camera for that. So it worked all in this big space. They want you to do two double crochets, chain one, then another double crochet, chain two, then another double crochet, chain one, and then two double crochet. No, yes, two double crochets worked in this last. I have an actual extra double crochet here. Or do I? No, two double crochets here. So let me just make sure I have it right again. They want me to do two double crochets. Oh, this one I'm counting. It's not one of them. Here we go. There. Two double crochets, chain one. One double crochet, chain two. One double crochet, chain one. And then two double crochets. All worked into this very end space here. And then now we're going to start continuing on this direction, working one double crochet in the next three stitches. One, two, and three. And then back post, double crochet around the next post. And then we'll be starting our repeat again, which is skip this next stitch, do the V-stitch, skip this next stitch. So basically you're just doing a V-stitch worked in your V-stitch. So double crochet, chain one, double crochet, V-stitching in your V-stitch. And then you're going to come over here where the next back post is, and you're going to work a back post on that. And then again, you'll work one double crochet in the next three stitches. And then a back post again. And then again, do your V-stitch and your V-stitch. You're going to be repeating this pattern like you were before until you get to the very end turning chain. Okay, I've done, I'm almost to the end. I've done my back post double crochet, and I've done my 1, 2, 3 double crochets, and now I'm going to finish this set by doing my back post double crochet, which brings me to the beginning, where we did our 2 double crochets in that beginning chain, then we chained 1 and did our double crochet. Here, they want you to do 1 double crochet in these next 2 stitches, and then in this space they want you to put 2 double crochets worked in this turning chain space here, and then chain 1 and do a double crochet in that third chain, and that will end row 23. So for row 24, there's a total of 27 rows here, so there's only 4 rows left. So for row 24, you're going to be chaining 4, 1, 2, 3, and 4, turn, and then they want you to put 2 double crochets in this beginning space here, 1 and 2, and then front post double crochet around the next stitch, so this very first stitch after the space here, do a front post double crochet there, and then skip the next stitch, and then you'll want to put a V-stitch. So skip this next double crochet, and then this next stitch here, you work a V-stitch of double crochet, chain 1 double crochet, and then skip the next stitch, and we'll start our repeat. So then we're going to skip the next stitch, and then our repeat is going to be a front post double crochet. So skip 1 stitch, and then the next, do a front post double crochet on this front post double crochet, and then again we'll be working 1 double crochet into the next 3 stitches. And then you'll work a front post double crochet around the front post double crochet. Good Lord, the noise. And then, of course, you'll be working a V-stitch in your V-stitch. So basically, you're repeating the last row now. So continue to repeat that all the way until they say 4 stitches before the area here, this big old area we did here. So continue until you've reached 4 stitches before the corner. Oh, I read ahead too much. They want you to continue the pattern all the way up until you get to this very end space. So I did my front post double crochet, got my 2 double crochets. Now this is my third. Then I'll do my front post again, which leaves me 2 end, which is basically a V-stitch. So once you finish that front post double crochet, then 1, 2, 3 double crochets, then your front post double crochet, you have this V-stitch. Just go ahead and put a V-stitch in this V-stitch. So double crochet, chain 1, double crochet, and that'll bring you right to this very corner space. And in this space, they want you to do a double crochet, chain 2, and double crochet worked in that very center, and then again they want you to do a V-stitch here in this next area here right after the big space. You're repeating what you did on the other side, so you're putting a V-stitch in this next V-stitch, which is double crochet, chain 1, double crochet. Then skip the next stitch, which is part of the V-stitch. They just want you to skip that and go right into the next stitch and do a front post. Whoops, front post, not back post. So this is your V-stitch. This is your V-stitch. This post is part of the V-stitch. So they want you to skip this one, go to the next, and do a front post double crochet around that one. Then now let me find where I am. Okay, then they double crochet like before. And the next three stitches, 1, 2, and 3. And then again, front post around this front post. Then you'll find your V-stitch here and then do your V-stitch in your V-stitch, which is double crochet, chain one, double crochet. Then you'll find your next front post here where you've been working them. So you're basically back on pattern again. And they want you to repeat this pattern like before until you get 4 stitches before the turning chain. So this is where the 4 stitches came in. They want you to keep the pattern going until you get 4 stitches before here. Okay, at the very end of row 4, I have my 4 stitches left. They want you to skip the next stitch and then the next do a V-stitch. So I'm skipping this one and then the next, doing a double crochet, chain one, double crochet, which gives me 2 stitches left. They want me to skip the next stitch and put a front post double crochet around this very last double crochet of the row. Oh, if I can get it in there. And then do 2 double crochets worked in the actual big space of the turning chain, like you usually do. And then chain one and work that double crochet in the third stitch, which is going to be hard, so I'm just going to go ahead and do it in the second stitch. As long as you can get it in there. There. And that's going to end row 24. So for row 25, it started just like all the rows, chaining 4, 1, 2, 3, and 4, and turn. Then you want to double crochet 2 in this very first space. Very first big old space here. 1 and 2. Double crochet in the next 2 stitches. So I'm going to double crochet 1 there, double crochet another there. Back post, double crochet on the next stitch. So here, and I can tell that it's already part of the row I got going there. So back post there. Then skip the next stitch, do your V-stitch. Okay, so basically do a V-stitch and the next V-stitch, just like you were doing before. And then you do a back post again on this next back post here. And then you're going to start the repeat. Yes. So now you're going to double crochet like before in the next 3 stitches. So 1, 2, and 3. And then you'll do one back post double crochet. And then it brings you to your V-stitches. Do a V-stitch in your V-stitch. Double crochet, chain one, double crochet. And then here you'll do your back post double crochet again. Then your 3 double crochets in your back post and you're right on schedule. V-stitch, right on schedule. I mean, right on the pattern again. They say they want you to continue to the center chain 2 space here. So continue your pattern until you get to the point. Okay, I just did my back post. Then my 3 double crochets, back post, and then I'm getting near to the end. I did my V-stitch here and my V-stitch, and I have basically 2 left, 2 stitches before the end. And I'm going to skip this next stitch and do a back post double crochet in this double crochet right before the end. So I'm going to go back here and do a back post double crochet in this last post before the end. And then in the big space itself, I'm going to work a large shell, which is 3 double crochets. 1, 2, and 3. Chain 2. And then 3 double crochets. 1, 2, and 3. And then I'm going to back post double crochet around this very first double crochet here. Then I'm going to V-stitch in my V-stitch here. Double crochet, chain 1, double crochet. And then you'll be on track again. You'll be working a back post double crochet. Then work 1 double crochet here. So you'll be back on the pattern again. And then I'll show you when you get to this corner. Okay, I just did my V-stitch. And I'm going to do my back post. They want you to keep working until you reach the last 2 stitches before the turning chain, which I am now. So I did my V stitch, my back post double crochet, and now with these 2 stitches, they want you to put 1 double crochet in both of those stitches. So there's 1 and 2, which brings us up to the last space. They want us to put 2 double crochets in that space. Chain 1 and work a double crochet in that third chain. Okay, for row 26, I want you to chain 4, turn, and then again in this big space in the beginning, the chain 1 space, I want you to put 2 double crochets worked in that space. Then a front post double crochet worked on this very first double crochet of the round, of the row, sorry. And then double crochet 1 in the next 3 stitches. So 1, 2, and 3. And then our repeat begins here. Will be a little different this round, this row, sorry. They want you to do a front post double crochet on the next stitch. And now this row in your V-stitches will be worked a little different. V-stitches this round row, why do I keep saying round? Will be 2 double crochets, chain 1, and 2 double crochets. So instead of double crochet, chain 1, double crochet, the V-stitches of this row will be 2 double crochets, chain 1, 2 double crochets. Then they want you to do a front post double crochet here where your front post double crochet is. And then again double crochet in the next 3 stitches. So it's going to be just like before. Front post here, front post double crochet, and then you'll reach your V stitch from last round. And again, this row you'll be doing 2 double crochets, chain 1, 2 double crochets. So that's the only difference. This row will be in your V stitches. Just going to be working your V stitch differently, but the rest will be worked the same. Front post, then 1 double crochet the next 3 stitches, then another front post double crochet, and then again in your V stitch will be 2 double crochets, chain 1, 2 double crochets. I'm getting close to my corner here. I mean my point. And I just did my shell. Not my shell, but you know, the V-stitch, the bigger V-stitch. And then I'm starting my front post double crochet here. Then I'm going to do 1 double crochet in the next 3 stitches, which will bring me right up to this point again. And you want to work a large shell in here now, which is 3 double crochets, chain 1, and then 3 double crochets worked all in the same stitch. And then again, you'll want to repeat exactly the same thing you did on the other side. So it'll be 1 double crochet, worked in the next three stitches. One, two, and three. And then you'll do your front post double crochet. Then you'll be back up to your V-stitch again. And it's going to be the same on this side as you did on the other. Two double crochets, chain one, two double crochets. And then again, do your front post double crochet. Then you'll continue your pattern of three double crochets and then the front post and then your V-stitch again of two double crochets, chain one, two double crochets. You want to continue that. It says repeat to turning chain. So you repeat that till you get to the end. Okay, I'm getting to the end of my row. Did my V-stitch here. Then I got my front post double crochet. Working my next three double crochets as usual. Then my front post double crochet worked on this last post, which will bring me right to this last space. And they want you to put two double crochets worked in this last end turning chain. Chain one and do your double crochet in that third chain. That will bring you to the end of row 26. Now for the last row, round 27, you only want to chain one and then turn. They want you to single crochet in this first stitch and then do a picot stitch, which is chain three. And then in this first chain you did slip stitch in there. So put your hook in there, pull it through that chain and then pull through your loop on your hook and then skip the next chain one space, so this big space here, and then single crochet in the next two stitches. One and two. Front post double crochet around the next stitch. So usually it's a place where you do a back post. They want you to pull that up and do a front post this time. And then single crochet in the next three stitches. So instead of doing your front post double crochet or your back post double crochet and then doing your three double crochets, this round you'll be doing your front post double crochet, three single crochets, and then a front post single crochet again. Worked on the post. I think I did a double crochet here. Yeah, I did. Whoops. This first, it's not supposed to be a double crochet. It's supposed to be a front post single crochet and then single crochet in the next. It's all single crochets, this round crochet and chain and picot. So I got three single crochets and then do a front post single crochet on this one. Okay. Now, single crochet, you're on your V that you did last time where you were doing your two double crochets. And then you'll be doing the first side of the V. You'll be doing two single crochets. One single crochet worked in each of those double crochets. And then here in this space, which is usually the place where you'll be doing your double crochets, you're going to skip it altogether because you're going to be doing a picot stitch over those. So you'll be chaining three, one, two, three. Slip stitch in this beginning chain and then the one on your hook to do the picot stitch. And now you're going to come on the other side here and do a single crochet in each of those other stitches. So it'll be two single crochets, picot stitch, and then two single crochets. And then you'll do here, where you would normally do your front post double crochet, your three double crochets, and front post double crochets. For this row, they'll be worked. All going to be a front post single crochet on those. And then the next three stitches, you will put one single crochet in each of those stitches. And then on the post, you'll do a single crochet. And then again, you'll repeat for the V stitches. You'll put one single crochet in each of the first two. Then you'll do your picot stitch of three, chain three, and then slip stitch to do your picot stitch. And then come on the other side of the V-stitch and single crochet in these next two single crochets. Then it'll bring you back to your next section where you'll do front post single crochet, three single crochets, and then a front post single crochet, which will bring you right back to your V-stitch again. Single crochet, picot, single crochet, and you'll be repeating this for the whole row. It says two stitches before the center. So you should have two stitches before you get the, what she calls, or they call the center here, which is the point. So you should stop here, have these two stitches before the end, and then I'll show you what to do. Okay, I'm coming to the end. Just did my front post single crochet, then I did my three normal crochets, and then I'm gonna do my front post single crochet, and it brings me up to the end where I now have two stitches left. And they want you to single crochet in these last two stitches, which will bring you back up to the very point. They want you to do a picot stitch. So one, two, three, do my picot stitch. Then skip the center chain and single crochet in the next two stitches. Then front post single crochet around the next post. Then single crochet in the next three stitches. One, two, and three. And I think that's gonna bring you back to the repeat. It says now we're gonna be repeating the next. I want you to single crochet front post around this next stitch, and then single crochet in the next two stitches. Yeah, and that'll bring us back up to where we were on the other side, because now there's the center of the V-stitch. So we do our picot stitch here, three, and then single crochet on the other two stitches on the other side of the V-stitch. And then it brings us back up to where we were before. So doing our front post single crochet, crochet one in the next three stitches, then front post single crochet, and then again you'll be here, single crochet, picot stitch, single crochet, and then you'll be right on track. So repeat this again until they say two stitches before the turning chain. So you'll be these two. So you'll end here on this last one, and then these last two in the turning chain should be where you stop. Okay, I'm up with the last two stitches. I just did my single crochet front post there to end my set of single crochet on the post, and then the three in the single crochet. So the last two stitches here, they want you to do one single crochet in both of them, which now you have the turning chain here. Do a picot stitch, one, two, three, slip stitch here, and then single crochet in that third chain. And now they want you to work in the ends of the row across the straight top. So along this top edge here, all along the top, this is where it's gonna fit here on your neck here. This is gonna hang down the front. It's this flat top edge at the very top, all along the top here, they want you to work two single crochets in each row all the way across. And then join with the slip stitch in the first single crochet of the round. So this first space here, you can see each of them has the space where we had the turning chain or double crochet. So there's a big space on the beginning of each row. They want you to put two single crochets in each of those. So do two single crochets, worked in each front stitch. and all the way across and do it. And then this beginning single crochet here, you'll just do a slip stitch, then chain one, cut your yarn, and then end it. And then you can hide all your tails that you've had to this point, because I'm sure you had some tails every time you changed rows and everything. And this is the side it's usually worn on, where you can see all the texture and everything on it. And that is it. For this tutorial, it does say homespun, but because it gives you a gauge, you can use any kind of yarn and whatever hook that you need in order. Because for this, for instance, I did the first four rows several times until I found the right kind of hook, right size hook I needed for this size yarn to get to the gauge I needed. So if you have thicker yarn, you probably can use a smaller hook to get the same size of the gauge that you need. So feel free to explore with your gauge, making sure that you have the right size. And if you want to make a bigger shawl, you can definitely stick with the 8mm and go with bigger yarn and have a bigger shawl. So that is it. I hope that you enjoyed this tutorial, and I want to thank Lion Brand for allowing me to do this tutorial. And I will definitely put a link to their website so that you can find the link to this pattern. I really encourage you guys to use the pattern with the tutorial so that you can see how it's written and how it translates into the pattern itself. So that's it. Thank you so much for watching, and please don't forget to like and share this video. You can like me on Facebook. I have a personal business page there. You can find all the links to where you can find me in the description box. And please don't forget to subscribe. Thank you so much for watching.